Need to lower the pulpit.
Great. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
God is working in our youth.
Amen.
We're going to teach. I'm going to teach on Proverbs 2. We're all going to turn to you. Can you, there's a cup of water. Proverbs 2, and I'm going to read it. My son, if you receive my words and treasure up my commandments with you, making your ear attentive to wisdom and inclining your heart to understanding. Yes, if you call out for insight and raise your voice for understanding, if you seek it like silver and search for it as for hidden treasures, then you will understand the fear of the Lord and find the knowledge of God. So I've got a little activity for, I guess, everybody doing their papers before I start teaching it.
Turn it face down. Don't look at it and put it face down. And then I need a volunteer. So make sure you have a piece, that piece of paper and a pencil or a pen.
or we spilled the water. parents giving you instructions, and you cut them off because, I know,
right.
What I want. Like, we already know how to do whatever it is. And then later, because we cut them off and did not hear the instructions clearly, or all the way out, when we go to carry out that task, we partially meet the need, and then it crashes and falls, making a big mess and sometimes bringing harm to yourself. Or we sit there in shame because now we need the instructions that they were freely going to give us because they love us. But because we cut them off thinking that we know everything, now we have to either figure it out ourselves, which normally does not end well, or suck up our pride and apologize and ask if they will explain to us or teach us whatever they were trying to say. All of that could have been avoided if we would or could have heard all of the instructions the first time. But instead, now we're left with that mess, all because we didn't want to hear. There's a key point in this part of the scripture. Being attentive is one, but the other one is, what are we supposed to be attentive to? Being attentive to wisdom. We can be and are attentive to many things, but are they the right things? We can become sidetracked and start paying more attention to foolishness than to wisdom, which is not wise at all. So what is wisdom? Wisdom is the quality of having experience, knowledge, and good judgment. Just like when your parent was trying to tell you whatever it was, they had that knowledge because they've been there before. They didn't want to listen to their parent before, and they're trying to forewarn you. But us as students, we know everything. In Deuteronomy chapter 5, we are given commandments. In chapter 6 and 3, chapter 6 verse 3 and verse 25, chapter 7 verse 11, and chapter 8 and verse 1, we are told over and over to be careful to do the commandments. Because if we're slack in any way, we can end up risking everything.
Amen.
All we have to do is listen to Him.
Yes.
If the animals, the rivers, the stars, and even the devils can listen and obey Him, we can too. We have to wake up in our minds and in our hearts that if we love Him, we will listen to Him. If we love Him, we will what?
Keep His commandments.
So, I was trying to think of an example in the Bible where somebody didn't listen to what they're supposed to do. But I went to Jeremiah. And the book of Jeremiah, basically, they have rules. They break the rules. They're in trouble with kids. They're warned over and over not to do bad things where there will be consequences. They still wouldn't repent. They were wise in their own eyes, and it ended in destruction, but not before He promised to renew the covenant with His people. Jeremiah 31 and 31. Jeremiah 4, verse 22. My people are foolish. They know me not. They are stupid children. They have no understanding. They are wise in doing evil. But how to do good they know not.
Wow.
That word foolish means they despise wisdom. They mock when they're guilty. They're quarrelsome. They feel free to do whatever they want. And later in that verse it says they are wise in doing evil. Wise meaning skillful, cunning or crafty, and doing evil. Jeremiah 6 and 10. Says, to whom should I speak and give warning, that they may hear? Behold, their ears are uncircumcised, and they cannot listen. Behold, the word of the Lord is to them an object of scorn. They take no pleasure in it. The first sentence there, it says, to whom should I speak and give warning? That they may hear, meaning Shema, meaning obey. And then later it says their ears are uncircumcised, and that means their ears are impure or defiled, that they cannot listen, be attentive. And the word of the Lord is to them an object of scorn, something that they despise. So all God wanted them to do was lay down their idols, their gods, their abominations, and repent, turning back to their husband, the one they first made covenant with. He gave them warning after warning, mercy after mercy, but they could not hear the warning because they had uncircumcised ears, meaning that their ears were impure and defiled. Why were their ears this way? Because they broke covenant and continued to follow after other gods, forsaking the way of their husband, who is the Most High God. Keeping our ears circumcised, undefiled, and pure not only allows us to hear His voice and what He is calling us to, but allows us to gain wisdom by following Him. His way is not to harm us, but to sharpen us. His way is upright and holy. So what is defiling our ears? Over the past months too, we have had a really serious plumbing issue in our sinks. Well, in our pipes that connect to the sinks. So if I ran the water from my bathroom sink just to brush my teeth, I would have a whole sink full of water and take forever to drain it. And then in the kitchen sink, water would back up and rush up. When we ran the dishwasher, whenever the water would be sucked out of the dishwasher, the water would run in the sink. Nasty. Disgusting. But anyways, Dad this past week hired a man to come out with everything and to see what the underlying issue was. They pulled out the pipes, and inside of the pipes were long hunks of built up greasy, nasty, disgusting stuff. Use your imagination. Anyways, we all know what goes into our ears and our eyes and comes out of our mouth. That is defiled. Yeah, a bunch of stuff. Because we have a filter called the Holy Ghost.
Wow.
When you hear, see, or say something that we know isn't quite right, we all know that tug that the Holy Ghost gives us. A toddler even knows when they've done something that they shouldn't, because they go and hide.
Yeah.
Does that sound familiar?
Come on.
Adam and Eve.
Right.
Yeah. Wow. Dealing with our sinks, years of pouring oil and grease and whatever else we want to take down the sink without care in the world led up to an issue that was threatening our health, because we did not filter every single thing that went down the drain. Mess built up. We didn't notice anything for the longest time. Everything was fine until the water finally backed up enough for it to bubble out. Just like the clogged up sinks. If we don't use the Holy Ghost as our filter, our pipes, meaning our spirit, will be junked up too. When we let things slip into our spirit that we think are just little and aren't real harms, and then we let another little thing slip in, and another, it builds up and builds up until it bubbles out. It bubbles out in the form of a bad attitude, a little back talking to mom and dad, or a snarky remark back to a friend. Is that the image of Christ? No. Let our filter do its job. If nothing dirty goes in, then nothing dirty can come out. Verse 3 in the Bible says, if you call out for insight meaning understanding, and raise your voice for understanding. Insight right there and understanding both have the same root meaning, to discern or consider. There is something that has been taught to me at school, and that is the best way to find out information that we need to know is simply ask. We don't know until we ask. So we have to speak up and speak out if we are wanting to gain wisdom or understanding. At times our pride might get in the way of us asking, or we might just be shocked. And we don't want anybody to think that we are dumb and we don't know anything. What others think about you shouldn't matter. We are all in different places in this journey. Especially during school, I've been asking him more recently than in the past. I ask God frequently to open up his wisdom to me and pour out understanding on me, especially in my difference. Matthew 7:7 says, ask and it shall be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it shall be opened to you. Verse 4 in Proverbs chapter 2. You seek it like silver, search for it as hidden treasures. So going back to what we treasure. Raise your hand if you have something you treasure. Who has a phone? That'd be like pretty cool. What if you lost that? What would you do? How would you act? Would it be a hot mess? So mom, I told her last night that I was going to use her as mom. Because I brought it up to her because that exact scenario was playing out before my eyes. I didn't realize that this happened so often. I said, y'all know mom, she's got glasses, and she has to have them. She has recently put a rope or what string or whatever it's called on so that she can keep them around her neck at all times so she won't lose them. And last night, she lost them. So what made her get something to make sure that she has them on her at all times? She was losing them so many times throughout the day that it was getting old. These things that she was losing was necessary for her to function in life. Because these are something that she treasured so much, when she lost them, she of course would look for them. But first, she would freak out because they were gone. Then she would search and search and search and search until she found them. So, all you kids, if I told you that I hid a $100 bill for each of you around this room, and you had to find it, and you're going to have it, what would you do?
What would you do?
Hey, what would you do?
This room would be tore up.
Kirsten, what would you do? You're going to search until you find that $100 bill. Because somebody just told you that it's there and it's yours. Go find it. You can have it. Because it's something of value to you. When something is of value to you, you will search until you find it. Job 28:28 says, and he said to man, behold, the fear of the Lord, that is wisdom. And to turn away from evil is understanding. Proverbs 9:10 says, the fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom, and the knowledge of the Holy One is insight or understanding. Proverbs 4, all of the young ones especially turn to Proverbs 4. And verse 20. There's just enough amount of young girls to read each verse from 20 to 27. So, starting at Lexi, like you read verse 20, then Emily read 21, all the way to 27, then I'll get there.
Okay.
Proverbs.
Therefore, consider the path for your feet, and all your ways will be established. Don't turn to the right or to the left. Keep your feet away from the other.
Those verses basically tell themselves what it means. I don't know. Elaborate on that. And then Proverbs 4:7 says, wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. So, what was the whole deal about sitting in the water and all the paperwork? Did anybody catch anything?
Yes.
Yes. Whatever it is.